Hello, I'm Chief Justice Robert Brutinel. I had the opportunity to meet many of you when I started my term as Chief Justice last July. I visited all 15 counties to meet with judges, clerks, court administrators, and staff. I enjoyed that experience, and I'm grateful that I had the chance to see your court facilities and to meet and talk with the people who are keeping our courts functioning. It was invaluable for understanding the challenges we face. I never imagined back then that we would be facing the health emergency that we are now dealing with. During this difficult time, our courts remain open, fulfilling our constitutional duties and serving the citizens of Arizona on essential matters. Many of our cases involve fundamental rights to freedom, to safety, to necessary treatment and care that won't wait for weeks or even days for resolution. To one degree or another, all of you have put yourself at risk to ensure that the critical work of the court continues during this crisis. While this message is for judicial branch officials and employees, I also plan to share this message of thanks with the public. It is important that the citizens of Arizona understand that we have you to thank for finding ways to continue providing essential services to the public, to ensuring the public's constitutional rights are upheld, and for maintaining the public's access to justice. Arizona courts work together on a 5-year strategic agenda. Trust me when I say that I had other projects and initiatives in mind when I titled the strategic agenda, Justice for the Future, Planning for Excellence. We are currently doing a lot of planning we didn't anticipate even 3 months ago. The plans that are now being implemented daily and weekly as we meet the challenges of this crisis are all geared towards justice and safety now and for the future. May 1st is Law Day, and this is a particularly relevant time to reflect on America's system of laws and justice in this time of uncertainty. Law Day is a time to appreciate the role of courts in ensuring the American ideal of fair and impartial justice. Thank you for the work you do in maintaining the honor and integrity of the courts. This year, I want to offer special thanks for your efforts in meeting the challenges created by the pandemic. The staff in our justice courts and municipal courts, generally the highest volume and busiest courts in terms of public contact, have borne a heavy burden. As the place where most people go for emergency orders, such as orders of protection, they had to remain open and accessible to the public and to do so safely. Thank you for your hard work and your cooperation with your presiding judges and with each other to get the job done. I want to thank court administrators at all levels of courts who have made access to our courts possible by arranging for phone and video conferences to enable judges to resolve emergency and essential matters without requiring parties to enter the courthouse. They've worked tirelessly with our presiding judges, clerks of court, and the administrative office of the courts to share information, implement ideas, and to support each other. Facility staff in courts and detention centers throughout the state, including here at the Supreme Court, are performing deep cleaning 7 days a week to ensure that those who enter our courthouses and buildings are safe. Our security staff work on the front lines, helping the public get in and out of our courthouses safely and efficiently. The court clerks, file counter staff, and others interacting with the public are working every day to fulfill the needs of court users, mindful of being available for what must be done in person and making those interactions as safe as they can be while maintaining quality service. Our adult and juvenile probation officers and surveillance officers have had great success in doing remote supervision and maintaining a safe social distance while not shying away from contact when required. They've been remarkably innovative in finding ways to protect the public while working safely. Our juvenile detention officers have done a fantastic job of keeping children detained in our centers safe. We mourn the loss of detention officer Stephen Chapman, who passed away from the virus. Our education services staff and field trainers have done a great job in transitioning from in-person education to remote learning. The court community and the public have benefited from them quickly finding ways to provide information and education in formats that we can all access remotely. On that topic, as I'm sure you're aware, we have canceled the judicial conference and we have waived the COJET requirements for judges and court employees. I encourage you to continue participating in such education anyway. We will continue to provide classes you can access online. And to our colleagues in the IT departments around the state, you have committed endless hours to what has to be the fastest transition from paper and in-person proceedings to electronic filing and digital appearances in our state's history. You have enabled Arizona's courts to remain available and responsive. You provided a lifeline as we were forced to make this transition. I also want to take a moment to thank the thousands of FCRB and CASA volunteers who continue to provide services during this health emergency. And since we won't be having a judicial conference, I'm pleased to announce that my colleagues and I voted to name Judge Diane Johnson of Division I of the Court of Appeals as the Judge of the Year. While we won't be able to present the award at the annual judicial conference, we will find an appropriate time to recognize her. Thank you to Arizona's judges at every level of court. Whether working from home or from the courtroom, you continue to advance the work of the courts, deciding cases, resolving disputes, making the system work, and showing by your example that, especially in difficult times, providing justice is crucial. Finally, I want to thank Arizona's presiding judges. In a time of work from home, these leaders have been at their courthouses solving problems and making the court system work. I thank you for your innovation, your hard work, and your willingness to lead. As Chief Justice, every year I get to recognize a person who has provided exceptional service to the courts with the Distinguished Service Award, the highest award we present for outstanding services to the Arizona courts. We honor that person at the Judicial Conference. This year, for the outstanding leadership provided during this pandemic crisis, I'm awarding the Distinguished Service Award to all 15 of Arizona's Superior Court presiding judges. To all the members of the judicial branch, your individual and team contributions everywhere in the state make it possible to ensure access to justice in Arizona. I thank you for your outstanding work in ensuring that Arizona's courts remain safe, accessible, and responsive to the public we serve. We don't yet know how long some of the changes we've implemented will be necessary. We are currently working on an administrative order outlining our plan for getting back to work and reopening the courts, which should issue soon. Some of the innovative practices that have been developed will continue beyond the current health emergency and will serve the public and our courts in the future. I trust the judicial leadership at all levels to reopen their county court systems when it's appropriate, consistent with that statewide order. When appropriate, we all look forward to having the public return to our courts, and I thank you for making that possible in a safe way. I am proud of each and every one of you. Be safe and stay well.